Hello, my name's Angela and I was injured in September 2018. So I woke up with excruciating pain and then went into my district hospital, subsequently went to a specialist hospital for surgery and then ended up in a spinal unit. And I was given the diagnosis of Cauda Equina Syndrome. Cauda Equina Syndrome is when the cauda equina nerves at the base of the spine get compromised and get squashed. And that means that it can affect your sensation and movement in your legs and below your injury. The surgeon told me or gave me the analogy that if my spinal cord is like the size of a tennis ball, mine was squashed to the size of a pea. So, you know, he said it was pretty severe when I had my surgery. But I was never expecting it to be a spinal cord injury, and I never thought you could get spinal cord injury through illness. I always thought spinal cord injuries were from something traumatic like a car accident, a bike accident, horse riding accident, something like that. In total, over all three hospitals, I spent about 14 weeks in hospital. Most of that was up in the spinal unit. And I run my own business, so it was really important to me because I used to be out and about meeting people, going to give lectures, talks, workshops. And after I went up to Sheffield, or just after the injury, I really thought I couldn't get back to doing any of that again. I couldn't see a future for me doing the work that I do. I first became aware of SIA when I was in the hospital after surgery, and my peer support worker, Chris Fitzjohn, turned up. And prior to that, I hadn't heard about the Spinal Injury Association at all. And Chris just came in, and at that point, I wasn't to know just how impactful he would be in my life. It was just such a wonderful service that I just didn't know existed. You know, Chris made me aware of all the support packages like SIA Healthcare, which I use, which have been really, really fantastic, and all the other services as well that SIA offer. So when I was thinking I couldn't do things, you know, Chris said, you can do things. There are ways around everything and everything is solvable. So he was just, I think, so powerful to my recovery and such a good role model of what you can do and how you can change things. It was also really, really useful to have the support of Chris for my family, because, you know, knowing that my husband and my sons could contact him for help and support in coping with my spinal cord injury as well was really, really good and just so helpful. And I know my husband really contacted Chris in the early days, and I'm so thankful to have some really close friends as well that have helped me. In particular, I've got a wonderful friend called Jackie who has been amazing in terms of, you know, taking me places. And she's just been so supportive, picking me up when I'm down, and when I've not wanted to do things or I've been a bit hesitant, she's just gently cajoled me into doing them, and it's always been the right thing to do, and she's always just made such a difference. So, you know, I'm just thankful for all that support from family, you know, from my whole extended family really, and all my friends. So it's nearly 12 months since my spinal cord injury, and I actually am quite pleased with the progress I've made. One of my main aims is to get back to driving. So I think that will really help me regain the independence, because I run my own business. And as part of that, I would go and visit groups to do sewing and run workshops and things like that. And I would often hop on and off planes as well. I am now able to get back to some of the shows I used to do. So these are shows where I go and I do teaching, and I think lots of people are surprised that I'm still doing it from my chair, but I'm very grateful that I can still teach and I've still got my hands to stitch with. So when I was in the spinal unit, I did actually design a kit, because one of the nurses there used to always say, everything is possible. So no matter what difficulty you face, or if something's hard, it's possible you might just need to find another way of doing it. So this is the kit that I designed when I was in the spinal unit. So this one's actually really special to me. Of all the kits I've done, I think this is the one I'm most proud of, because it's the one I did after my surgery, after my spinal cord injury, and it just means such a lot to me.